Hello everyone, welcome to Deepthi's biology class. In this lesson, we will be starting with the female reproductive system. So we have already covered the male reproductive system. Here we are discussing the structure of female reproductive system. Once we understand the structure, we will go deep into the functions they perform. Now, the human female reproductive system is specialized to support the process of gametogenesis, ovulation, fertilization, pregnancy, birth and child care. So the organs which support in all these process together form the female reproductive system, right? So in case of male, we have seen the male spermatogenesis or gametogenesis plus the transfer of the sperm into female, that much system forms the male reproductive system. But in case of female, from the gametogenesis or gamete formation till the child care, not only the child birth, once the child is born, right, mammary gland is required to feed with milk, right, that also comes under the female reproductive system. So which are the parts? A pair of ovaries, oviducts, uterus, cervix, vagina, external genitalia and mammary glands. These all parts together form the female reproductive system. Now, this is that overall diagram. This is a side view, right? So this is the front side of the body and this is the back side of the body. You can understand this is the backbone, right? So if you look at this diagram, you can understand. See, here is the urinary bladder, here is the uterus, which means from the uterus, the ovum or the sperm will be reaching to the uterus through this pathway, or else we can say that once the fetus is developed, it will be coming out through this way, right? So for the urine, there is another opening and the undigested food material comes through this opening. So in simply we can say, in case of male, both urine as well as, so in case of male, what was there? For urine and sperm, there was single opening. Do you remember that? But in case of female reproductive system, for the removal of urine, there is one opening. Menstruation as well as the birth of the baby, that takes place through the another vaginal opening, right? And so you can understand this way, right? So this is the digestive system, but because it is labeled as rectum. So this is one side view. We'll see all these parts in detail. It is not that clear in this diagram. So once again, what difference you have to make from this diagram? In case of male, there will be single passage for both urine as well as the gametes, right? But in case of female, there will be different passage for urine as well as, so this is the urethra here and here will be the vaginal orifice or vaginal opening, right? So let's see detail structure. So before that, I will show you the diagram of female reproductive system which you supposed to draw when it is asked. So if the question is asked, draw a detailed diagram of female reproductive system, you need to draw this diagram, right? Now, once I will complete from this diagram and then we'll go back to the points. Now, the female reproductive system consists of, mainly here there is ovary, right? Fallopian tube. So, the first part we can write here, this is number one. Then, fallopian tube. Then, the third one, that is the uterus. Fourth one is the cervix and the fifth one is the vagina, right? So how many parts from this diagram we got? One is the ovary, second one is the fallopian tube, third one is this uterus. Uterus, these three layers forms the uterus, right? Then the fourth one is cervix and the fifth one is vagina, right? So which are the parts of reproductive system? Ovary, or pair of ovaries, right? These two. Then fallopian tube is there. So this much forms the fallopian tube. This much is the fallopian tube. Followed by this much, that is the uterus. Uterus followed by this narrow canal, that is cervix. Then there will be this vagina. Vagina opens into external genitalia. So external genitalia is not there in this particular diagram, right? Now let's start with ovary. So how many ovaries are there? There are pair of ovaries, see right side and left side. So you have to remember ovum or the egg which is produced in this ovary. We are right now just seeing only the location and the structure. We are not going into the detail how the ovum is produced right now, right? So what is the function of the ovary? Ovary has two function. One is to produce ova or egg. Second is to produce hormones, female ovarian hormones. We will see which are those hormones and all. Now, whenever the ovum is released by the ovary, it pass into the fallopian tube. So which part of the fallopian tube collect? Fimbriae. What is this fimbriae? Is that fimbriae is this finger like structures which are here. So it is like this. So if this is the tube of fallopian tube, at one end it is funnel shaped. This funnel we call it as infundibulum, like this. See, infundibulum. At the tip of this funnel there is finger like projections which are there, which has a suction force to suck the ovum. So if the ovary is here, the ovum is released. This ovum is sucked by this fimbriae. So you can see these finger like projections are termed as fimbriae. So then where it goes? Now let's see the structure of this fallopian tube, then we'll connect it. Fallopian tube consists of mainly three parts: infundibulum, ampulla and isthmus. Infundibulum, ampullae and isthmus. So infundibulum is the funnel like structure which receives the egg, which in turn collected by the fimbriae. So fimbriae collect the egg from the ovary to this funnel shaped structure, we call it as infundibulum. Then it passes to the region called ampulla. Suppose see this way, there will be this fimbriae, then funnel shaped structure is there. After, so this will be the infundibulum, this will be the fimbriae, and later there will be a swollen, slightly swollen structure, then the tube will continue. This swollen part is termed as ampullae. So that much is not clear in this one, but this swollen region we call it as ampullae. So what happens in ampullae? In this ampullae, fertilization takes place. So in ampullae what happens? Fertilization takes place, which means the male sperm which comes through this way has to reach here for fertilization. Are you getting the point? So once this ovum is released through the fimbriae or with the help of fimbriae via infundibulum, it reaches in this ampullae. Now this egg will wait here for around 3 days, we can say, or sometime it will wait there, that we will see in detail. So this egg will wait here for some time. If it get a chance to fertilize with the sperm, or if it encounter a sperm here, there will be fertilization takes place, right? So there will be ampullae followed by isthmus. So understand, if fertilization takes place, what will happen? It will form the zygote. That zygote will come back and will implant in this particular uterus. That is again deep, right? We'll see that. So what the fallopian tube has? Infundibulum, ampullae and isthmus. So this side also it will be there. This will be the fimbriae. This funnel shaped structure is going to be infundibulum. This swollen portion is going to be the ampullae. And this narrow tube like portion we call it as isthmus, right? Both the side it will be there. Now what will be there? There is a chamber, a muscular chamber. This chamber is termed as uterus. So this much is the uterus. Not only this much, see this wall, these all are the part of uterus only. We can say this is the uterine cavity, and this much. This much forms the uterus. So which consists of different layers. So let's see what are the layers of this uterus. Uterus consists of outermost layer called perimetrium. Middle layer we call it as myometrium, and the innermost layer is termed as endometrium. So if the question is asked exactly where the implantation takes place, what is implantation? You know, I told you, if fertilization takes place in ampulla, there will be zygote formed. zygote will come and implant into this endometrium, innermost layer, into the innermost layer implantation takes place. So we will say that implantation takes place in the endometrium of the uterine wall. So uterine wall consists of three layers, which are the endometrium, myometrium and perimetrium. Now you have to remember few things related to these layers. Now this perimetrium is a membranous layer which is having actually a membrane. Now myometrium, myosin and all you have studied somewhere, right? It is a, so this is membranous, and myometrium is muscular layer, and the innermost one, endometrium, is actually the glandular layer. So remember, these layers are richly supplied with blood also. So every, you might have heard about the menstruation, right? Every month what happens, this endometrium get ruptured and removed, or it is removed as menstrual flow. Again this layer will develop. Why this layer is getting developed? If the fertilization takes place, zygote need to be implanted, so there should be a muscular layer to be, you know, a muscular layer or glandular layer should be there to support this one, right? That's why there is development of these layer, right? This is richly supplied with blood and all. Now if there is no fertilization, no zygote will come to implant, hormone level changes and this wall ruptures and comes out as the menstruation, right? Now followed by this uterus, there is, see, uterus leads to a narrow channel, we call it as cervix. So this much is the cervix, this much is the cervix, and the space in the cervix we call it as cervical canal, right? This all having some important role, or we can say there is important role at the time of childbirth, right? All these layers get contract when the baby need to be delivered. Now followed by the cervix, there is a portion we call it as vagina. Now the cervical canal plus vagina, these two together we call it as birth canal. This is the pathway for the baby to come out. So let's once again quickly see what this female reproductive structure consists of, right? Now the female reproductive system consists of pair of ovaries, right? Ovary produces ovarian hormones as well as ovum, right? The ovum will be passed on to fallopian tube, which is collected by the fimbriae. It passes through infundibulum and reaches the ampulla. If it finds sperm there, it get fertilized, right? If there is copulation, what is copulation? Transfer of sperm from male to female. Definitely the sperm has the tail, it is going to swim. There will be millions of sperm, it will come, it will swim, it move to both the way, right? If the ovum is released from here, it will wait here. If it is released from here, that will be waiting there. If this ovum find sperm there, fertilization takes place in ampulla. Now the zygote is going to travel through the isthmus, it will reaches to this uterus, right? So this space is called uterine cavity, and all these projected muscular area we call it as uterine fundus and all, right? So it has this fundus, the body part, all these things we will see in detail, especially when we study the uterus. This is the basic structure now. So what the uterus consists of? Uterus is a three-layered structure which consists of perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. Now what happens? This uterine canal is followed by cervix. Cervix area has a narrow space, this space is termed as cervical canal. Cervix leads to vagina. Vagina also having this vaginal cavity, right? Or space is there. Now these two things together we call it as birth canal. Now let's see, right? Okay. So the ovaries are the primary female sex organs. So what is the meaning of primary female sex organs? These are capable to produce the sex cells, right? Now they produce the female gamete called ovum. They also produce steroid hormone, which is also termed as ovarian hormones. Now the length is 2 to 4 centimeter, which is connected to the pelvic bowl and uterus by ligaments. So how it is connected to the body wall or the pelvic bone? We know that pelvic bone is there, right? To the body, the lower abdominal region, it is connected to the body. So you have to remember this way. This ovary is connected to the body wall as well as to the, so you can see one line is here, right? This is actually the ligament which connects. This ovary is connected to the body wall also, even it is connected to the uterus also, right? Now each ovary is covered by a thin epithelium. Each ovary has a thin epithelial covering. It is not clear here. So thin epithelium. So what this epithelium? So inside the ovary, what is there? Each ovary covered by epithelium, and inside the ovary there will be ovarian stroma. Now see, if this is the ovary, right, this membrane we call it as ovarian epithelium. Now inside this, whatever is there, we call it as stroma. This stroma is divided into two. So these outer region, so this way we can divide, right? This outer region we call it as peripheral cortex, and this inner region we call it as medulla. We know that wherever outer region is there cortex, inner region we study as medulla, right? So in case of ovary, when we study in detail, we will understand the membrane we call it as ovarian epithelium. Inside whatever is there, we call it as stroma. The stroma has this outer portion, we call it as peripheral cortex, and this inner region we call it as medulla. Why do we study this region is that once we study in detail, you should understand where the ovum is there, whether the ovum is developing in the outer cortex or else it is developing in the medulla. All these things are important. So what is there inside the, what is the structure which is present inside the ovary? Ovary has matrix, we call it as stroma. Stroma has peripheral cortex and inner medulla. Now the next thing we are going to study under the heading accessory ducts. So which are the duct or a tube like structure or a channel through which sex cells or zygote or fetus, whatever it can go, right? So that consists of oviduct, uterus and vagina. Oviducts are nothing but fallopian tube. So which are the duct? Duct is this much. So we know now there will be outer cortex and inner medulla. So this all act as a tube like a channel it is, right? So this much portion form the accessory duct. So the first duct is fallopian tube or oviduct. So oviduct or fallopian tube, in case of male it was sperm duct, right? The one which carry the sperm. We have studied in a vas efferens, vas deferens, these all are the ducts, right, in case of male. Now each fallopian tube is 10 to 12 centimeter long. It extends from the periphery of each ovary to the uterus, right? So from where it starts, if you look at this diagram, it start from one side is connected to ovary, another side is connected to the uterus. Now infundibulum is the funnel shaped part closer to the ovary. We know that, right? Fimbriae is the finger like projections at the edges of the infundibulum that aid in collecting the ovum after ovulation. So this ovary releases ovum after ovulation, which is collected by this fimbriae, then it goes to the infundibulum. What is ampulla? It is a wider part of the oviduct after the infundibulum. So we can say that infundibulum is a funnel shaped structure. Ampulla is slightly swollen structure or wider structure. Isthmus is the last part of the oviduct. It has a narrow lumen and joins to the uterus. So it is a narrow lumen. What is lumen? The space, or this is very narrow. Isthmus is very narrow tube-like structure which is connected to the uterus. Now what about uterus? Uterus is also termed as womb. It is shaped like an inverted pear. It is attached to the pelvic wall by ligament. So uterus is also, ovary is also attached to the pelvic bone or pelvic wall of the body, and ovary also, both. So ovary is attached, ovary and uterus is attached to each other. So you have to understand this ovary and uterus are attached to each other, one way of connection. Second thing, independently this ovary is connected. So behind this diagram you have to imagine there is pelvic wall. So this is attached to the pelvic wall also. This uterus is also attached to the pelvic wall. Means this entire structure is supported to the pelvic wall by ligaments. Uterus is the part where the embryo develops into the fetus, right? So the uterus opens into the vagina through a narrow cervix. Uterine wall has three layers or tissues. We can say that three layers of tissues are there: perimetrium, myometrium and endometrium. So we have seen, right, these three layers which are there. Now perimetrium is the thin external membranous layer. Myometrium is a thick middle layer made up of smooth muscles. So I told you, this is muscular layer. It exhibits strong contraction during the delivery of the baby. So when this muscular layer contracts, it helps in the ejection of the baby. Endometrium is the inner glandular layer that lines the uterine cavity. It undergoes periodic changes during the menstrual cycle. So as I told you, this inner layer, this area get ruptures during menstrual cycle. Which layer it is? This wave-like layer which we are saying, this is actually the endometrium, right? So what about cervix? Cervix is a narrow canal connecting the uterus to the vagina. Cervical canal is the cavity of the cervix that we have already discussed. What is birth canal? Cervical canal plus the space in vagina. So as I told you, this much, this two together we call it as birth canal. So these spaces, right? So this space plus this space together form the birth canal. Right, now this topic we will see in the next video lesson, where we will study the external female genitalia and mammary gland. So from this one, these many portions were there, right? So we have covered ovaries, oviduct, uterus, cervix and vagina we have covered partially. So along with external genitalia, we will study all these parts in detail. Thank you for watching. We'll complete this particular topic in the next lesson.